Okay, so I had a question from Laura in London asking me if I'm positive all of the time, baby. No. I would do your nutting if I was positive all of the time. All of the time. But I'm going to dig a bit deeper into that question, Laura, and for anyone else who wants to be a bit more positive. Something that I hear from clients and people who do my 7-day happiness reset is, how can I be more positive? Really, what you want is to have that better inner dialogue and to be able to shift your perception of something much more quickly. The problem that most of us fall into is that we're just not aware enough in the moment when we're falling into a negative story, when we're writing something in our minds about a situation that actually makes us feel stuck in it. Do you ever do that? Sometimes I just think about things from the past, or what I might say to someone if I saw them in the supermarket, or that person who bumped me on the tube. I used to do that one a lot. And I could pull that story around and around, and then suddenly I am feeling angry and I am feeling frustrated or jealous or annoyed. And it's really not a great thing to do, because it means you're not being present and you really do need to let that go. So how do you become more positive on a daily basis? One, let it go, let it go. Let it go. Whatever it is that is churning in your mind, just start to say those words. Let it go, let it go, let it go. Actually, I've got something even better for you. So what I used to do when I was stuck in a negative dialogue with myself, I would use this prefix, which was what I want to think is. Because what we do naturally is start to say to ourselves, oh, you're so stupid, or stop thinking that, or oh, it's so annoying, I can't get this out of my head. And we're meeting negativity with more negativity. So there's nothing there, like magnets, right? They're just gonna stick to each other and it's gonna become stronger and stronger. For me, it felt like, have you ever watched that movie, The Blob? I used to feel like I had a blob in my head, and it was this dark energy that would just feed off more dark energy. So I realized you need to get some positive in there. Now, using that prefix, what I want to think is, start to pull you out of that state. And it's not trying to convince yourself that you can think it, because obviously your mind is stuck on something, but it's setting an intention for it. So what I want to think is, and then I would insert my vision for being here in Ibiza. What I want to think is that one day I'm going to be running my business living in Ibiza. And I would just play it over and over and over, whilst also going to do something different. Go and get a glass of water, get up from where you are, do some kind of different activity to shake up those neuro pathways and start to move you out of the negative and into the positive. Number two is, write what you want to think all around your house. I do this all the time. So if you want to start thinking that you are enough, or you want to start thinking that you are beautiful just as you are, or that you are successful, or that you can succeed in finding love, or you deserve love, whatever it is that you need, try not to rely on this to remember that you want it to be more positive. It's like relying on the thing that you want to change to remember that it needs to change. It's quite difficult. So use your environment to support you. Write it on your mirror, write it on your fridge, put it on your laptop. I actually got, you know those wall stickers you can get, the writing? I don't have it now because I've moved house. I tried to peel it off like a cheapskate and keep it, and then stick it up again, it wouldn't work. So I just need to buy it again. But I think I'll do something else. Anyway, another conversation. But I had I am grateful, and I stuck that up because I just really wanted to make that a part of like my DNA, and it really worked, so try it. Number three is, switch on first thing. You may have seen this on some of my social media channels, but during the Happiness Reset, my 7-day program, I ask people to do a happiness switch on, which is really an early morning practice that you do first thing as soon as you wake up, to to switch on and into the person you want to be and what you want to do for that day and what you want to think. So often we wake up first thing and we just allow ourselves to fall into automatic. Ugh, I don't want to go to work, or I hate my boyfriend, or my kids are so annoying, or the house is so messy, I've got so much to do, my life is boring. That one is like one of my automatics. Oh, I'm so bored, my life is boring. And I have to take care to be switched on and into who I really want to be, because that is not a dialogue that serves me. So you ask yourself three questions. Who do I want to be today? What is it that I want to think? And what am I going to do to bring those things to life? Simple as that, 5 minutes as soon as you wake up. So am I positive every single day? No, however, there is positivity in me all of the time. And really that choice is mine in any given moment to choose a different dialogue, to change my perception. And over the years, I am working to master that and I'm getting much, much better at it, so I can do it very, very quickly. So I do feel like I'm positive most of the time, but you know, sometimes things just piss us off. And hey, that's okay. It's your decision to make. If you know that maybe you could be more positive, then it's probably a sign that the relationship you have with yourself needs some work. And when you start to work on the relationship you have with yourself, good things happen. So I'm excited for you. I want to hear from you. What have you taken from this video today?